Hello everyone. So now here we will see one example on rectification of errors, and errors are detected at the stage after preparing a trial balance. So let's first read this. Trial balance of Abhinav did not agree. He located the following errors. 1. Sales return book was overcast by ₹4,100. Then second, goods returned to R Limited ₹2,500 were recorded through sales book. Third, credit purchases from ABC and company ₹15,000 were recorded through sales book. Fourth, purchases book was undercast by ₹1,000. Fifth, in the sales book, total of page 4 was carried forward to page 5 as ₹1,000 instead of ₹1,200, and total of page 8 was carried forward to page 9 as ₹5,600 instead of ₹5,000. Credit purchases from PQR and company ₹6,000 were recorded through sales book. However, PQR and company were correctly credited. 7. Salary paid ₹2,000 was debited to employee's personal account. Rectify entries assuming situation 1, suspense account is not prepared. Situation 2, trial balance did not match. It shows an excess of ₹9,300 credit. So suspense account is prepared. So now when the errors are detected after preparing trial balance, there may be two cases. So in first case, suspense account is not prepared. In the second case, the suspense account is prepared. So what has happened is trial balance did not match. Okay, so the credit side of the trial balance was showing 9,300 in excess. So your suspense account will show that the same balance. To match your trial balance, we have prepared a suspense account, and the same amount of 9,300 was parked in the suspense account. So suspense account is showing a debit balance of 9,300. So now what we will do is we will first solve rectify all these entries considering situation 1, that is suspense account is not prepared, and then we will see what will be the change in the rectification entries in situation 2 as compared to situation 1, that is when the suspense account is prepared. So now first we will pass an entry assuming that suspense account is not prepared, and then we will come back to each and every transaction to see what all will change when the suspense account is prepared. Okay, so first is sales return book overcast by 4,100. So overcasting is an totaling error. So what has happened is sales return book overcast means, say suppose for a particular day your sales was 1,000. So instead of 1,000, sales return, the total in the sales return book was considered as 5,100. So because of which what has happened is that same entry of 5,100 was posted in your sales return account. So because of which your sales return account is showing an excess of 4,100. Actual balance in the sales return account should have been 1,000, but it is showing a balance of 5,100. So it is showing an excess balance of 4,100. Now sales return account will have a debit balance. What is the entry for the sales return? Entry for the sales return is sales return account debit to debtors account. So sales return account will show a debit balance. So since it is overcast by 4,100, now your debtors, this is one sided error wherein your book is overcast by 4,100. The other effect of this entry is correct. So on the credit side of the sales return account, we'll write by overcasting of sales return book and 4,100. because of which your sales return account balance will be corrected. First one. So on the credit side of sales return account, right, by overcasting of sales return book and 2100. Now here we'll leave some space, okay, so that we can also find out what is an entry in situation 2 later on. Now the next transaction. Second, goods returned to R Limited rupees 2500 were recorded through sales book. So goods returned, so they to R Limited, so they are your purchase returns. So the entry for the purchase return will be R Limited to purchase return, but they are recorded in the sales book. So entry that was done is R Limited to sales 2500. So we need to rectify this entry. Let's do that. So second, we have left some space after first transaction to see the effect of the transaction or rectification in situation 2. So now the second will write. So what has happened is entry that is passed is R's account debit 2500 to sales. Reversal of this wrong entry will be sales account debit to R's account. The correct entry should have been your R's account debit to purchase return account 2500. This should have been the correct entry. So now the net effect of this two will be your rectified entry. So R's account get cancelled. So the entry, rectified entry is sales account debit 2500 to purchase return account 2500. So what we have done is we have taken it out from the sales and we have added it to a purchase return account. But the R account is correctly debited by 2500, so there is no impact of on the R account because of this rectification entry. Now the next one. 3. Credit purchases from ABC and company rupees 15,000 were recorded through sales book. So there was credit purchases which was recorded through sales book. So let's see this. 3. So there was purchases and it was wrongly considered as sales. So what has happened is ABC and company account debit to sales account. This is the entry which has been passed. Amount is 15,000. Now reversal of this entry will be sales account debit to ABC and company account 15,000. So what should have been the correct entry? The correct entry should have been your purchases account debit 15,000 to ABC and company 15,000. So the rectification entry will be net impact of these two entries. Now what has happened is sales account debit 15,000, purchases account debit 15,000. Now ABC is credited by 15,000 here, ABC is credited by 15,000 here. So total amount is 30,000. So the rectification entry will be sales account debit 15,000, purchases account debit 15,000 to ABC and company 30,000. This is a rectification entry. So we have taken out 15,000 from sales. We have added 15,000 to purchase, and ABC account was wrongly debited by 15,000. So we have reversed that impact. And in addition to that, since there are purchases from ABC account, we have to credit him by 15,000. So the total impact of 30,000 has come on the credit side of ABC account. Now the next one. Fourth, purchases book was undercast by 1,000. So undercast is your purchase total book. There is a totaling error in the purchase book. So what has happened is, say for example, total purchases for a particular day was 5,000. Instead of 5,000, the total was only 4,000. And this 4,000 was recorded in the purchases also. So what has happened? Your purchases has been recorded less by 1,000. So this entry will have only one impact. So on the debit side of your purchase account, we will write two undercast of purchase book 1,000. Fourth one, so your purchase account will show a debit balance. So it is showing a debit balance which is less by 1,000. So on debit side of purchase account, we'll write two undercast of purchase book and the amount is 1,000. Now the next one. Fifth, in sales book, total of page 4 was carried forward to page 5 as rupees 1,000 instead of 1,200. And total of page 8 was carried forward to page 9 as 5,600 instead of 5,000. Again, these are errors of commission. So now what has happened here is, now instead of 1,200, which is the actual sales, the amount carried forward is 1,000. So now because of this, your sales day book is showing 200 less. Then in the second transaction, what has happened is, instead of 5,000, it has been carried forward as 5,600. So the sales day book is showing 600 more. So now the net impact of this is that your sales day book is showing 400 more balance. Okay, so sales day book is overcasted by 400. So what has happened because of this? In your sales account, the sales is shown more to the extent of 400. So we need to reduce this. So sales account will show a credit balance. So on the debit side of the sales account, we'll write two errors in balance carry forward, and the net impact will be 400. So on the debit side, of sales account, two errors in the balance carry forward rectified, and the net amount is 400. So what has happened because of this? The sales balance has reduced by 400, and your sales account is reflected correctly. Next. 6. Credit purchases from PQR and company rupees 6000 were recorded through sales book. However, PQR company was correctly credited. Now, what has happened in this case is credit purchases from PQR and company. So, the entry should have been purchases account debit to PQR and company. But what has happened is PQR and company is correctly credited. But instead of purchase book, it has been written in the sales book. So, what has happened is PQR and company is credited by 6000. Your sales account is also credited by 6000 since it is recorded in the sales book. But there is no debit entry. So, this has one impact. Okay. So, now what we need to do in your sales book, we need to reduce 6000 and then on the purchases, we have to add 6000. But since PQR and company was correctly credited, we need not rectify the balance in the PQR and company. So let's do this. So, 6th one. So now PQR and company, what has happened is on the credit side of PQR and company, it has been properly recorded as 6000. Then in sales account also it has been shown as a sales. So on the credit side of the sales it has been recorded as 6000. So we need to reduce this. So, on the debit side of sales account, we have to write two purchases wrongly recorded in sales book, and it is 6000. So this will rectify the balance in the sales account. Then now these purchases need to be recorded in your purchase. So on the debit side of purchase account, I have to write. Now this purchases to PQR should have been original entry. So to PQR account unrecorded. Amount is 6000. So now by this our purchase account is also rectified. Now since PQR account is correctly credited, we need not change it. Next. 7. Salary paid rupees 2000 was debited to employee's personal account. So instead of employee's personal account, it should have been considered as expense. Now let's see a rectification entry for this. What has happened is employee's personal account is debited. So employee's account debit to bank. Now reversal of this wrong entry is bank account debit to employee's account. What should have been a correct entry? Correct entry should have been your salary expense account debit to bank account. So the rectification entry will be net effect of these two. So the bank account gets cancelled. So rectification entry is salary account debit 2000 to employees account 2000. This is a rectification entry. Now we have seen all the entries in situation 1 when suspense account is not prepared. Now let's see how to rectify this entries in situation 2 when the suspense account is prepared. So when the suspense account is prepared, what happens is your trial balance doesn't match. Now in this case, it is showing an excess credit of 9,300. So same amount is parked in the suspense account. That is, one suspense account is created to park the balance amount in the trial balance to match it. So suspense account is currently showing a debit balance of 9,300. Now what will happen is, wherein the rectification entries there is a complete rectification entry wherein it is impacting two accounts, that account will not be reflected in your trial balance. So trial balance mismatch may not happen because of those rectification entries. So those rectification entries will remain same. But where we have posted a partial entry in a particular sales account or in a particular account, so that partial entry wherein we have posted that those errors, because of those errors, the trial balance will not match. So those errors are reflected in the suspense account and they are parked in the suspense account. So there will be some change in your entries for those accounts, okay, wherein we have passed a partial entry. Now let's see all this one by one. So see, first is sales return book overcast by rupees 4,100. Now in this case, what has happened is there is a partial entry. So on the credit side of sales return account, we have returned it as by overcasting of sales return book. So now what has happened, because of this overcasting of sales return book, it is a one-sided error. So your trial balance did not match because of this. So now this amount has been parked to your suspense account. So when we have prepared the suspense account, your entry in situation 2 here will be, see, on the credit side of sales return account. So we have to credit our sales return account. So the debit will be suspense account. So suspense account debit 4,100 to sales return account 4,100. This will be the entry for this overcasting of sales return book. Now the next one. 2. Goods returned to R Limited rupees 2,500 were recorded through sales book. Now this goods returned was a purchase return which was recorded in the sales book. Now let's see the entry for this. Now the rectification entry for this is sales account debit 2,500 to purchase return account 2,500. Now this is a complete rectification entry. This is not a partial entry. So because of this error, there was no difference in the trial balance. So the suspense account which is showing some balance is not because of this error. So this will remain same. This rectification entry will remain same even in the situation 2. That is when the trial balance is prepared and suspense account is created. Same. Okay, so there is no change in this rectification entry. Now the next one. 3. Credit purchases from ABC and company rupees 15,000 were recorded through sales book. So, 3rd. Now, what is a rectification entry here? Rectification entry is your credit purchases is recorded as sales. So, rectification entry is sales account debit, purchase account debit to ABC and company account. Again, this is a complete entry, rectification entry. Now, because of this complete rectification entry, now the suspense account is not affected. So because of this error, your trial balance will not have any suspense account. Your trial balance will match because of this error. So in even in the situation 2 wherein the suspense account is prepared, the entry will be same. Okay, the next one. Fourth, purchases book was undercast by rupees 1000. So now fourth one, on the debit side of purchase account to undercast of purchase book rupees 1000. So now this is again a one-sided error. Because of this, what has happened is your purchase account was showing a balance of 1000 less, but the second impact of this was already given. So there will be a difference in the trial balance because of this entry. Now in this case, when we prepare a suspense account, our suspense account will be affected. So now in situation 2, the entry for this is, since purchases was recorded less, we will debit purchase account. So purchase account debit 1000 to suspense account 1000. Next, in sales book, total of page 4 was carried forward to page 5 as rupees 1000 instead of 1200, and total of page 8 was carried forward to page 9 as rupees 5600 instead of 5000. Now in this case, what has happened is there was an error in the balance carry forward in the sales book, because of which the sales was overcasted by 400. The net impact was 400. Again, this is a one-sided error. That is, because of this, the trial balance did not match. So when we prepare a suspense account, the entry will be, see, there was an overcasting of the sales. So sales account was showing an excess credit of 400. So we have to debit the sales account. So entry will be sales account debit 400 to suspense account 400. Now the next one. Six, credit purchase from PQR and company 6000 were recorded through sales book. However, PQR and company were correctly credited. Now in this case, what has happened is PQR and company are correctly credited, but credit purchases was considered as a sales. So your purchase account is not debited by 6000, and instead your sales account is credited by 6000. So now let's see the impact of this transaction. So because of this what has happened is credit side of PQR is correctly credited. Now what has happened, sales account was credited by 6000. Actually there was no sales. So on the debit side of the sales account, we wrote it as two purchases wrongly recorded in the sales book 6000, and on the debit side of the purchase account, we had recorded unrecorded purchases of 6000. So again, this is a partial entry. So because of this error, our trial balance will not match. So suspense account will be affected because of this. So now in case wherein we are preparing a suspense account, your entry will be, see, your sales was recorded when there was no actual sales. So sales account was showing an excess credit balance. So we will say debit it. So sales account debit 6000. Then we have to record our unrecorded purchases. So purchase account debit 6000 to suspense account, an amount is 12000. Next, seven, salary paid rupees 2000 was debited to employee's account. So the rectification entry for this is salary account debit to employee's account. Again, this is a complete rectification entry. So because of this error, the trial balance will match. So there is no effect in the suspense account, and the entry will be same even if we have suspense account. That is, entry will be same in the situation two. Now, to summarize this situation one and situation two, let's say when we prepare a suspense account, only those entries because of which our trial balance will not match will be routed through suspense account, whereas other errors, okay, wherein because of which our trial balance will have no impact and it will match, that will remain same. So in other words, we can say that wherein we pass a complete rectification entry which impacts both the accounts equally, in that case suspense account will not be impacted and those entries will remain same. But in case wherein we pass a partial entries wherein the error is only one-sided and because of which the trial balance will not match, those entries will be routed through your suspense account. Now we will prepare a suspense account and we will post the entries, all these entries in the suspense account, and see if the balance in the suspense account is nil after rectifying all the entries. Now I have prepared a suspense account here. Now as we know that the credit balance was shown more in the trial balance by 9,300. So on the debit side of the suspense account, I'll write it as to excess of credit over debit amount is 9,300. Now we will see the entries which are impacting the suspense account and we will post those entries in the suspense account. Now this is the first transaction. In this entry is impacting a suspense account, so it is suspense account debit 4100 to sales return account 4100. So on the debit side of suspense account, on the debit side here, to sales return account 4100. Next, now this second transaction entry will be same even if we maintain the suspense account, so no impact on the suspense account. So we'll just see the next transaction. For next transaction also, the entry is a complete entry and it is not affecting a suspense account. Then the next transaction, number four. So here again the entry is passed, purchase account debit to suspense account, so it is affecting a suspense account. So on the credit side of suspense account, on the credit side of the suspense account, by purchase account 1000. Next, fifth, again the transaction fifth is affecting a suspense account, sales account debit 400 to suspense account 400. So on the credit side of the suspense account, by sales, on the credit side of suspense account, by sales 6th transaction, number 6. Again the transaction number 6 is also affecting a suspense account, so on the credit side of the suspense account we will have by sales 6000, by purchases 6000. On the credit side, by sales, 6,000. By purchases, 6,000. Next, transaction 7. Now this account, this error is not affecting a suspense account, so there will not be any impact of the suspense account. Now this was all the errors. Now what we will do is we will go to suspense account and see if the suspense account is balanced and there is no balance in the suspense account. So this is a suspense account. So let's see what is the total of debit and credit side. So total of the debit side is 13,400 and total of this is 13,400. So there is no balance in the suspense account. So once we rectify all these entries, your suspense account should tally. So this was about an example wherein we prepared a trial balance and then the errors were detected, and then we saw two approaches wherein the suspense account is prepared and one more approaches where the suspense account is not prepared.